All puppies are sweet and cute, yours will be no different. Chihuahuas are a unique dog breed that they fall in love quickly with their owners. But don't often have any interest in meeting other people or other dogs. They are very comfortable within their own spaces. So to teach them to be friendly, you need to expand their personal space. In today's video, you will learn how to train your Chihuahua to be friendly. Before we go on, don't forget to like and share if you enjoy our content. Please hit the subscribe button to get notified when we post more pet-related content. Liking and sharing our content helps massively with the growth of our channel. So it's very much appreciated. Defining tasks. The trick to train your Chihuahua to be friendly from the start is to get him social as early as possible. If you are adopting a Chihuahua puppy into your family, let as many people handle him as possible as soon as you bring him home. If you have other dogs in your household, let them also interact under your close supervision. Let your Chihuahua and your other pets explore and get to know one another. You can also teach an older one to be friendly. It just may take more time for some of the older doggos because they are set in their ways and need to learn new behaviors. The boundaries method. As leader of the pack in your house, teach your Chihuahua all the commands he can learn. Start with the basics to get him to sit and lie down on command. Then move on to cute tricks like standing on hind legs, rolling over, or begging. Little dogs can learn a lot of fun tricks that will give him positive attention when performed. Be sure to end any training session with treats along with the treats he earns while learning. Do not let your Chihuahua free feed. Provide his meals on a set schedule. If it's possible, train your Chihuahua to stand back away from you while you are preparing the meal and putting it in place. Once your dog has gone through obedience training, has been socialized, understands who feeds him and his role while waiting for his meals, and knows he has to earn his place on the couch or in your spaces, put all these things together and have him around people and pets more. The respect training method. Establishing the leader of the pack role with your dog and demand respect for yourself. Over time, he will get that you expect him to be respectful of others as well. Set your boundaries early on. If your Chihuahua is acting aggressively or growling, put him down or do not pick him up to begin with. Babying or coddling this behavior will only make it worse for your Chihuahua. Do not discipline your dog with angry voices or tones. Yelling at your Chihuahua only sends mixed messages of aggression and anger. Remain calm and redirect your pup when you see him misbehaving or acting in an aggressive manner. In all occasions as you see fit, from walking out the door to feeding times, have him wait for what he wants. Walk through the doorway first, holding it open for your pup to follow. Have your Chihuahua watch you prepare a meal and make him sit and wait patiently as you set the bowl down before he is allowed to eat. If your dog has learned commands from you, is social, knows to work for what he wants, and respects you, he will carry that respect around to others as well. The set rules method. Before you bring a Chihuahua into your home, decide your boundaries. Set boundaries with sleeping arrangements, whether or not your pup will sleep in your bed, be allowed on your couch, or be held much of the time. Your Chihuahua will growl a lot, especially as he is meeting people and pets in your world. Do not allow him to get away with growling at your guests. Do not show him affection or hold him if he's going to be aggressive. Be firm and ignore poor behavior but overly reward good behaviors. Get your dog out as often as possible to see the big wide world. He needs to be comfortable with people coming into your home and other pets being near you. A Chihuahua who is not well socialized will stick to his owner and fear anyone else. Let people hold or pet him while he's on the ground. Always end social time, training time, good behavior, and affection moments with a treat. The number of euthanized animals could be reduced dramatically if more people adopted pets instead of buying them. When you adopt, you save a loving animal by making them part of your family and open up shelter space for another animal who might desperately need it, and get a new best friend out of the deal. Seriously, what could be better than that?